Let's get back to Brisbane. So the Premier taking questions now. This is him after having responded to an independent review on the Olympics. It said build a new stadium in Victoria Park. He's saying he doesn't want to do so.
It's possible that the staging of the warm-up track and the athletics track can still allow for it to be used throughout, but we need to do that work. Oh, we've been working on this plan in recent weeks. Obviously, we didn't cook it up in the cabinet room. I asked when it was clear the direction the panel was heading in. I indicated to our public servants that we needed another option. We were aware the panel would consider those two options, and I asked for more detail to be done on an option two because I knew that it was going to be very, very hard to accept a brand new $3.4 billion stadium without any of that planning work, effectively starting from scratch. Well, I think this is a great value games. It delivers us three upgraded stadiums and the new arena. So this is closer to what I was looking for. I indicated when I did the review that there were no perfect solutions, no easy solutions. If there was, we would have found them sooner. But this is an alternative that allows us to stay within our funding envelope, deliver those legacy benefits, particularly around public transport and connectivity, invest in wider public transport projects like Sunshine Coast Direct Rail. So I see this as the best value option. Oh, this is very much about what is the best plan for the Olympic and Paralympic Games. And I think when you look at it, it is a good value outcome at a time when Queenslanders are struggling with housing costs and other costs. I don't see how I could have justified pouring another $1 billion into the Games funding envelope. I was determined to stay within the existing envelope. Well, that will be up to them, and you'll have to ask them their position. This is our position. Well, I don't see a scenario where a future government demolishes the Gabba after we've invested so much to build the public transport infrastructure there, to deliver the urban renewal there, and to connect it to South Bank and back across the river to the City Botanic Garden. So I think the Gabba, the iconic Gabba, will always be a stadium. I note that the report didn't calculate what it would cost to demolish the Gabba after building their new stadium at Victoria Park. That would only add to those costs. We are accepting 27 of the 30 recommendations. It is a good report. We don't agree necessarily with the Olympic overlay costs that have been incorporated into the QSAC costing in the document. We will work with the IOC to get that number down, but this is a plan that delivers to Queensland three upgraded venues, plus the arena, plus all of those other community sporting locations.
All right, so that's Steven Miles. As you kept hearing there, he said we're agreeing to 27 of the 30 recommendations. The big one was a new stadium in Victoria Park, $3.4 billion. This report basically said the Gabba's tired. The rebuild there is not a good idea in terms of value for money, so do a new one at Victoria Park. That's not going to happen, Steven Miles said. We don't want to bulldoze the Gabba, given the transport links they've developed there. This report, though, also said the Gabba basically is going to come to the end of its life in the next few years, so he wants clearly value for money. Unclear what happens in terms of what the Gabba might need in terms of upgrade. For the Olympics, it will be about Suncorp mainly in terms of the opening and closing ceremonies and also some of the events, but it's not big enough for athletics, so that will be out at QSAC, that venue built in the 1980s. That gets an upgrade as well. So big decision that has been made here to go against, well, clearly the biggest recommendation in this report was that new stadium. That's not going to go ahead under the Labor government. So another fascinating injection into that Queensland election, which will happen later this year.